कृष्णचैतन्यदेव श्रीराधा कृष्णपादान सगणवृता श्री विशाखान्वितश्च नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनि नमः। नमस्ते सरस्वती देवी गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम हरे राम राम राम। So we are in discussing Mantra 17 and almost we started this last Friday. Devotees can mute so that we can hear it audible. Other devotees who are there in their mute, they can mute themselves. This is a mantra which we are saying. Padma Mataji, can you mute your...
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Can you mute your system? Yeah, thank you. So this is a shloka which we discussed. Vayuranilam amritam atedam bashmantam shariram om kratasmaro kratam smara krito smara kratam smara. Let this temporary body be burnt to ashes and let the air of life be merged with the totality of air. Now, O my Lord, please remember all my sacrifices, and because you are the ultimate beneficiary, please remember all that I have done for you. So Srila Prabhupada takes from this Vayur Anilam Amritam Atedam Bashmantam Shariram. The first almost 40% of the purport Prabhupada speaks on Shariram, and we saw it in the last session. This is a concluding session of the Ishopanishad. This is prayer section. Prabhupada would have spoken on Shuddha Bhakti and love of Godhead and all those things. Prabhupada speaking about again here, we are not the body, we are spirit soul. So this is like Prabhupada utilizing this opportunity to preach. So because it's not so easy to come out of the bodily platform of consciousness, because we are in the material world, the modes are so strong. Despite our all endeavors to get out of these three modes, but modes are so strong that they'll pull us back. But the only hope is Maya Adhyakshina Prakriti Sviyate Sacharachara Hetunani Kamite Jagati Parivartite. This Prakriti is Krishna's Prakriti. So when we surrender, we can easily surpass, not on our strength, but based on Lord's strength. That is what you think. So we have been seeing, I'll just brief what all things Prabhupada covers in this purport. Initially, at least we saw these 2 points in the last session. Material body is a foreign dress and is formless. It takes a shape according to the form of the soul. Someone's mic is on. Vinaya Mataji, can you move off the system? Yeah, thank you. And so material body is foreign dress. And soul is eternal. Because soul has a form, body has a form. We saw this. Material bodies are tailor-made according to the living entity's desire for sense gratification. We saw, according to the soul's desire, there are 84 lakh species. So one can reach the highest perfectional stage in this human form by surrendering unto the Supreme Lord and developing one's sense of spiritual service. So we saw this earlier 2 paragraphs. We saw this almost this huge big paragraph. Prabhupada speaks about this thing. You see, in first 3 paragraph, Prabhupada speaks about material body, Shariram. He emphasizes on Shariram. And then in the 3rd paragraph, Prabhupada speaks Shariram is durlabham, arthatam. It is valuable. The highest developed form in this human form, when it is possessed of all sense of spiritual knowledge. Basically, once we get the human form of life, by culture of knowledge, we should surrender to Vasudev. And that Prabhupada ends this paragraph with that. The culture of knowledge reaches perfection only when the knower comes to the point of surrendering to the Supreme Lord Vasudev. Otherwise, even after attaining knowledge of one's spiritual identity, if one does not come to the point of knowing that the living entities are eternal parts and parcels of the whole and can never become the whole, one has to fall down again into the material atmosphere. Indeed, one must fall down even if he has become one with Brahmarupa. Basically, one has to utilize the human form of life for culturing knowledge, that is, the personality of God, understanding the personality, Sambhutim, and the Vidya, not the so-called Vidya or so-called Sambhuti. Okay, so then, so till here, Brahma Jyoti, we have finished last. Basically, Prabhupada is taking the point Shariram. He is emphasizing this Sharira is formless, the soul has a form, and the body accepts the form of the soul. And as soon as the soul goes off, it starts decaying. And in the next second part, Prabhupada speaks, we change bodies based on consciousness, based on the living entity's desire. The bodies are tailor-made. So if we desire to serve Krishna in this life by practicing Vaidisadhana Bhakti and then Raganuga, then Bhava, then Prema, then at the end of this, we get a spiritual form in the spiritual world. And for that, the Prabhupada says, the most important form, therefore human form is the only form out of 84 lakh species in which you can realize that consciousness of serving God. And we can elevate ourselves from this material platform to the spiritual world. That is possible only in the human form of life. So yes, devotees can read. I think many devotees have raised hands. Santosh Adityapur can read from here. This is the last paragraph of this third section. Then we'll go ahead with the further discussion. Yeah.
Hare Krishna.
Yes.
As we have learned from the previous mantras, the Brahma Jyoti emanating from the transcendental body of the Lord is full of spiritual sparks that are individual entities with a full sense of existence. Sometimes these living entities want to enjoy their senses and therefore they are placed in the material world to become false lords under the dictation of the senses. The desire for lordship is the material disease of the living being. For under the spell of sense enjoyment, it transmigrates through the various bodies manifested in the material world. Becoming one with Brahma Jyoti does not represent mature knowledge. Only by surrendering unto the Lord completely and developing one's sense of spiritual service does one reach the highest perfection stage.
Yes. Basically, the culture of so-called Vidya or the worship of so-called Sambhutim is not the mature knowledge, but the culture of real Vidya, that is Krishna Ishavasham principle, that Lord Shri Krishna is a Bhukta, Bhuktaram Gitapasam, and that Sambhutim is worshipping the personality of Godhead, that is the highest perfectional stage. Therefore, so Shariram, the human form of life in the Bharata Varsha should be utilized for, one can reach the highest perfectional stage in the human form by surrendering unto the Supreme Lord and developing one's sense of spiritual service. Surrender means service. Prabhupada translated bhakti not as devotion. Prabhupada translated bhakti as devotional service. Therefore, this human form of life should be utilized for surrendering unto the Lord by cultivating, culturing Vidya, worshipping Sambhutim, and then rendering service to Him, awakening the spiritual sense of service. Then it becomes complete. So, after speaking about the human form of life, how the human form of life is so rare, and how one should surrender, culture knowledge in this human form of life, Prabhupada speaks about this prayer. Prabhupada is going to speak about the prayer where Krito Smara Kritam Smara, Krito Smara Kritam Smara. So, four times Smara is being spoken here. So, Prabhupada brings out a point, even if a devotee, because of some reason, somebody is traveling somewhere and there is 10-12 years back when some devotees from a Chaupati were traveling to Muktinath, suddenly there was a plane crash and they left their body. So there can be times, situations where somebody is going through a car and he gets accident, and somebody is just sleeping at night, he gets a heart attack. So there are conditions in Rishabhdev section, fifth canto, there is a Sukhdev Goswami mentions of Parikshit Maharaj that how different people can die. Somebody can slip and die. Somebody can get a Prajwara and leave his body. Somebody is just sitting and he's trying to eat something and while eating something he eats which is poisonous, he may leave a body. So there are different situations are mentioned where a person can leave a body. But if somebody has practiced bhakti or somebody is chanting the holy names of the Lord, then that will protect him. Like we can see in Ajami section also, he has not cultivated. Initially he used to worship the Shaligram Chila to some extent. But still, because of unknowingly chanting the Lord's name, he got a second chance. So therefore, Prabhupada brings out a point that even if at time of death a devotee does not remember his service to the Lord does not forget him. Because there are chances, because a devotee is in the foreign atmosphere, he is in a foreign body, he is into surrounded by so much of material energy around. And because of so many obstacles in this material world, it may happen that at the time of death, prana prayanaka samaya kapavata pitta kanta varadana svarnam kutashta. It's King Kulasekara is telling that Krishna tvadiya pada pankaja panjarantam adeva vishatume manasa raja hamsa prana prayana samaya kapavata pitta kanta varadana vidho svarnam kutashta. So King Kulasekara is praying right now, man, hale and healthy. All the three substance in the body, kapha, vata, pitta are balanced. I can chant your names, I can get up for Mangalarti, attend the whole morning program, and I can think of you, I can hear, attend Bhakti Shastri, I can write these exams, I can read Bhagavatam, I can preach, I can go and work, everything. But when the time of death comes, Bhagavatam mentions so many things, different situations which one has to undergo. The whole kapha vata pitta, the whole throat starts rattling when a person is about to leave the body. Then there is a difference between a devotee leaving a body who is purified, who is a pure devotee, and normal people. But again, it's not very simple. It's not so easy. Death means, it's like, you know, you are sitting suddenly and somebody comes and takes you, okay, you empty this whole room. You're sitting in a nice apartment in your Hyderabad area and suddenly somebody comes and, you know, comes out, some 4-5 will come out and take you out and throw you from the window. You'll start defending yourself. So giving up this body is not so easy because we are so attached to the body. And therefore, sometimes people who are attached to the body, they sometimes, when they're leaving the body, they sometimes pass urine and stool because of the fear when they see Yamdutas when they approach them. So people are sometimes they go into coma. The time is over, but the living entity is hanging over to the body that it doesn't want to leave the body. So in such condition, it should not happen that devotees should come across such condition, but will of the providence, we don't know what happened with us. There are so many fortunate devotees who are surrounded by wonderful devotees around them, and they're chanting Hare Krishna and they're trying to remind them of Krishna. Sometimes some of the gurus also come and sit around some of the devotees and they are able to give them their association, make them remind about the Krishna. Wonderful story comes in the His Holiness Indradhumi Maharaj of the disciple, lady disciple from Russia, Varshila Mataji. Indradhumi Maharaj writes a book about her. It's 92-93 she came to Bhakti. Then within 1 year, she shifted to, she became very, very serious, got initiated. And then she got diagnosed that she had some cancer. And then immediately she shifted in 93 or 99, within 6 months she shifted to Vrindavan. And within 6 months, whatever she could do, she did all the parikramas, did Govardhan parikrama, chanted extra rounds, took complete shelter of devotees and different spiritual masters, sannyasis. And at the end, Indradhumi Maharaj reached there to remind his disciple to remember Krishna at the time of death, and surrounded many wonderful souls, great devotees. In 94, she left her body. Within 2-3 years, that's it. So we may be fortunate, if Krishna willing. We may not be fortunate. Sometimes some devotees may go in coma. Sometimes somebody may go in a plane crash. So, but devotee doesn't have to worry so much. In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna tells in Uttarayana, Dakshinayana, a person has to leave. If somebody lives in Dakshinayana, then he goes a different path, he follows. Somebody lives in Uttarayana, he follows a different path. But Prabhupada writes there, but devotee doesn't have to worry about it. Somebody is practicing Krishna consciousness, somebody is trying to chant his round, somebody is trying to be able to follow Redo principles quickly, somebody has full faith in Guru, Hari Guru and Vaishnavas, Lord takes care of him. So one devotee asks a question to Prabhupada, some sannyasi, so if you are not able to remember Krishna at the time of death, what will happen? And then the answer was, Krishna will remember, because Krishna is conscious, he is Abhigna Swarat, he is in everybody's heart. And therefore, this is the next section, that even if at time of death, a devotee does not remember his service to the Lord does not forget him. Therefore, if we take one step to the Lord, Lord takes 1,000 steps towards us. And his steps are not like us. His steps are like Vamadeva's steps, huge. Within 3 steps, he can cover the whole Brahmanda. Okay? So let's go ahead with this. Anand Raman Roo, can you read this section?
Hare Krishna Prabhu, Dandavat Prabhu.
Hare Krishna.
In this mantra, the living entities praise to the enter the spiritual kingdom of God after relinquishing his material body and material air. The devotee prays to the Lord to remember his activities and the sacrifices he has performed before his material body is turned into ashes. He makes this prayer at the time of death with full consciousness of his past deeds and of the ultimate goal. One who is completely under the rule of material nature remembers the heinous activities he performed during the existence of his material body, and consequently he gets another material body after death. The Bhagavad Gita 8.6 confirms this truth. Yam yam vapi smaran bhavam tvajati ante kalevaram tam tam evaiti kaunteya sada tad bhava bhavitah. Whatever state of being one remembers when he quits his body, O son of Kunti, that state he will attain without fail. Thus the mind carries the living entity's propensities into the next life. Unlike the simple animals who have no developed mind, the dying human being can remember the activities of his life like dreams at night. Therefore, his mind remains surcharged with material desires, and consequently, he cannot enter into the spiritual kingdom with a spiritual body. The devotees, however, develop a sense of love for God by practicing devotional service to the Lord. Even if at the time of death, a devotee does not remember his service to the Lord does not forget him. This prayer is given to remind the Lord of the devotee's sacrifices. But even if there is no such reminder, the Lord does not forget the service rendered by his pure devotee. Hare Krishna.
Yeah. So in this section, Prabhupada writes a very nice point. One who is completely under the rule of material nature remembers the heinous acts he performed during the existence of his material body, and consequently he gets another material body after death. So that is what we see most of the times when people are very attached, especially if somebody is a doctor, somebody is working in the hospital. We can see most of the people who are very sinful, they die on the new moon day, on the Amavasya day, because that is the time when they go to their darkest destination. And the how is the way they leave their bodies? They leave their bodies passing stool, passing urine, and all kind of things. Basically from the lower holes. That means it's a lower destination. It's a path. It's like they will go to the lower destination and then animal species in the next life, not a human species. So because the living entities are simply attached to eating, sleeping, mating, and defending like animals, then they are creating a path from where to eject their soul from. Therefore, yogis generally, when they do this yoga siddhis, sometimes when the goal is to go to Swarga, they do karma kanda. And the goal is to go to Tapaloka and other things, they start doing Ashtanga yoga. Jnana yoga, they come to Jnana yoga, and slowly they come to Ashtanga. They start performing siddhis, anima, lagima, and everything. And the only goal you have seen that one of the book, Prabhupada has written, is his journey to other planets. A yogi is sitting with his big nails, with everything covered by all the bushes, say a land. In the background, a tiger is seeing him, and the moon is there, and his eyes are closed with all sorts of surroundings, the very, very thick jungle bushes. He's trying to rise his soul from the Mooladhar Chakra, Vajnadhar Chakra, and from the Brukuti. Sahasrarandra, he makes a hole and ejects and goes to whichever planet he wants. And Prabhupada writes in that book, if this yogi wants, he can go to even to spiritual world also. It's called Skrama Mukti. But he doesn't want it, because he thinks that, okay, he wants to do siddhis. He's after siddhi. So it's not easy. Therefore, for a person who is very much attached materially, in sense enjoyment, he makes a pathway to eject his body from the hole which he is using a lot for enjoyment. Sometimes they can see some devotee, some people, outside people, they can use their body omitting. So higher destination, they may go to Swarga or some other thing. That means, okay, there could be else there. But for devotees, somebody's practice bhakti, doesn't matter in what situation, how he is, how he lives, how he doesn't lose. Because why? He is in the path which is right path. That is the next discussion. When a devotee is there, and sometimes a devotee may come to bhakti, and despite coming to bhakti, because of his past habits, he may be seen performing some sinful activities occasionally without his unintentional sins. So because of that also, what happens is the devotee prays at the end of the life that knowingly or unknowingly I may have committed some sinful activities after taking a resolution also. So how Lord protects his devotee? That is mentioned in the next section now. So Prabhupada step by step is coming that, okay, we have body, this body is sharira. Based on desires, we accept different bodies. But bhakti is the only purpose of this body and service to Lord. While doing that, even if we do service, we should think this, that, okay, even if somebody doesn't appreciate, but Lord is always seeing us as super soul within our heart and he remembers it. And sometimes he will not only remember service, sometimes he can remember also our past sinful activities. But what Lord sees, like when Putna came to him, he closed his eyes. Why? Because she has come with the attitude of service. Let me accept her service. And let me not see this, okay, she's putting poison and other things with Kalakuta poison. So that is how Acharya is right. Therefore, in Maitreya Rishi, Uddhava recites this shloka when Vidura asks him, so what happened to the Lord? Has Lord departed from this world? Before giving that information, he says that, how can I stay in separation apart from the Lord? So he says a very, very nice shloka about Putana. Stana Kalakutam Jigam Sipayad Apya Sadvi Lebigatim Datri Uchitam Tatonyam Kimva Dayalum Sharanam Rujanya. So he says that how can somebody who has taken shelter of Krishna, who is even delivering the woman which has come to kill him, but seeing the devotional aspect of her, that she has come to feed me milk like a mother, he gave her the elevation to become nurse in the spiritual world under Yashoda Mai. So Lebe Gatim Datri Uchitam Tatonyam Kimva Dayalum Sharanam Rujanya. So who else apart from Krishna I can go and take shelter of? None other than Krishna. That is the glory of the Lord. So Lord knows everything. He knows the positive. He is an expert SWOT analyst. Strength, weakness, opportunities, threats of each and every person in this world. But what Lord does, he removes threats and weaknesses. And he sees strengths and he sees opportunities in his devotees. And in fact, for all living entities. And that is only hope. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the magnanimity is an example of that. So, path of devotional service is the only right path, and occasional occurrences of worldliness does not hamper one in the advancement of self-realization. So, we can see the merciful nature of the Lord, but we should not take it for granted. For okay, Lord is so merciful, I am so patita, I have come in the Kali Yuga, so let me continue my sinful plan. No. This is occasional occurrences of worldliness, not a sanction for us to keep on doing in the name of, okay, I'll chant Krishna also, I'll continue my program of worldliness also by committing sinful activities. Oh, anyway, it is a conditioning, you know. So this is a license for me. That is not the case. So Lord has a very intimate relation with his devotees. So this section has two parts. How Lord is so merciful to his devotees. And second part is how we have to see how Lord sees the devotee who has that kind of conditioning. And Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur gives the purport of Sudarachara about that. So we can request next devotee to read this purport. Sri Girashpur, please can you read this purport? Continuing with this, Lord's intimate relation with his devotees.
Harekshiva Vudanakana.
Yeah.
Lord's intimate relation. Excuse me. Lord's intimate relationship with his devotees. The Lord clearly describes his intimate relationship with his devotees in the Bhagavad Gita 9.30 and 34. Even if one commits the most abominable action, if he is engaged in devotional service, he is to be considered saintly, because is properly situated in his determination. He quickly becomes righteous and attains lasting peace. O son of Kunti, declare it boldly that my devotee never perishes. O son of Pruta, those who take shelter in me, though they be of lower birth, women, Vaishyas, merchants, as well as Shudras, workers, can attain the supreme destination. How much more this is so of the righteous Brahmanas, the devotees and the saintly kings. Therefore, having come to this temporary miserable world, engage in loving service unto me. Engage your mind always in thinking of me. Become my devotee. Offer obeisances to me and worship me. Being completely absorbed in me, surely you will come to me. Hare Krishna. Thank you.
So basically here, this is the first part of that thing, Sudra-achara. So Lord clearly describes the intimate relationship with devotees in Bhagavad Gita. So this is 9:30 to 34. So Lord is telling that whoever it might be, if they can practice bhakti, and by engaging me in manmana bhava mat bhakto madhyaji mamuro. So that is a shloka which Prabhupada quotes here. So can the next devotee, Deepa Mataji, can you read the next section?
Hare Krishna Prabhupada.
Yeah.
The real purport of the word Sudurachara, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakura explains these verses in this way. One should regard a devotee of Krishna to be on the right path of the saints. Even though such a devotee may seem to be a durachara, a person of loose character, one should try to understand the real purport of the word Sudurachara. A conditioned soul has to act for double functions, namely for the maintenance of the body and again for self-realization. Social status, mental development, cleanliness, austerity, nourishment, and the struggle for existence are all for the maintenance of the body. The self-realization part of one's activities is executed in one's occupation as a devotee of the Lord, and one performs actions in that connection also. One must perform these two different functions along parallel lines because a conditioned soul cannot give up the maintenance of the body. The proportion of activities for maintenance of the body decreases, however, in proportion to the increase in devotional service. As long as the proportion of devotional service does not come to the right point, there is a chance for an occasional exhibition of worldliness. But it should be noted that such worldliness cannot continue for long because by the grace of the Lord, such imperfections will come to an end very shortly. Therefore, the path of devotional service is the only right path. If one is on the right path, even an occasional occurrence of worldliness does not hamper one in the advancement of self-realization. Hare Krishna.
So what Prabhupada says here is the most important thing. So because we are in the material world, we have body, cross body, we have subtle body, and we have so much of conditionings. So because of that, when we come in the path of bhakti, the conditionings may carry forward from the previous lives, our pre-Krishna conscious life. But when we are trying to practice bhakti, we have two functions. One is body and then self-realization. In body, he is telling about, Prabhupada speaks about social status, mental development, cleanliness, austerity, nourishment, struggle for existence, for the body. That means basically, physical, intellectual, mental or emotional, social, all these things. And then spiritual, that is the self of science, the self-realization part. But one must perform these two different functions, parallel lines, balance, vertical and horizontal, thus balanced. And because the conditioned soul cannot give up the maintenance of his body, because we have the body, we can't just stop physically, stop eating prasad. We can't just intellectual engagement, emotional, mental engagement. We need it. We can't deny it. And therefore, one has to continue that. At the same time, the proportion of activities and maintenance of body decreases in proportion to the increase in devotional service. Slowly, 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 when we start chanting, we initially come to bhakti, start chanting, hearing, we feel it relevant. We see outside what Prabhupada is speaking in his books, makes sense. And then we start seeing the whole world through the eyes of Shastra Chakshu. Then slowly we start chanting 16 rounds. We start following four principles. Then we come to the point of Diksha. And then as we keep on progressing again and again, anarthas will pop up. And we keep on chanting. We keep on taking guidance by the help of six running exchanges. mentioned in Nectar of Instruction, verse 4. We continue on the journey. But as we continue the journey, as we grow more and more, with age, if you are sincerely under proper guidance practicing bhakti, the maturity dawns. And slowly, slowly, a person starts taking a lot of responsibilities, personal responsibility in terms of one's own practice, and also in terms of organizational responsibility. And what happens is that at one point of time, as long as the proportion of devotion does not come to the right point, there is a chance for an occasional exhibition of worldliness. Therefore, initially, it may take some time. When you come in the first 5 years, 10 years of a practice of bhakti, but over a period of 15 years when you're practicing bhakti, then slowly, slowly, the maturity dawns. For some people, it can quickly, based on the past progress in the past life when they come to bhakti. For some people, it might take a lot of time. But this is a formative year. First 15 years of bhakti is a very formative year. If during that time we can cross the first 15 years of bhakti with faith, with determination, with patience, then we understand problem is not others. We are ourselves the problem. We start understanding, okay, I have an issue, not others are the problem. I am the problem. And one takes responsibility for one's life and for one's actions. And then one takes, after taking the responsibility, he can take bhakti very, very seriously. Then he will understand, okay, I have to work on myself, not on others. I can't stop others. I can't stop others from commenting. I can't stop others from popping into my business. But yes, despite whatever others do, I have to carry on with my own practice of bhakti. So, but it should be noted, such worldliness cannot continue for long. So what happens is, Lord is sitting in our heart as a Paramatma. So Teshaam Sudhaktanam Bhatam Priti Purvakam Dadami Buddhyogam Tam Tenamam Upayantyate. So Rupa says, even if while going on a proper path, you want to go to some destination, and sometimes there can be some, you are going a four-wheeler or in a train or some other bus, and there is a puncture of tire gets punctured or the engine gets shut down. The vehicle may wait for some time. But as soon as the vehicle gets repaired, it starts, continues. There is guarantee that it will reach a destination. Similarly, those who are in practice of bhakti, a path of devotional service, they are on the right path. They are on the right vidya, culture of vidya, or worship of samyuti. Therefore, occasionally there might be some worldliness. Doesn't happen in the sense that for the time being, they may wait for some time, but they can continue immediately. Like a case of Bharat Maharaj. Time being, he got attached to a deer. But then, even in the next life, like a deer's body, he continued bhakti. And even the next life as Brahmana's son, he continued bhakti. And then that is the glory of bhakti. That bhakti is the right path. So even if sometimes one may get attached knowingly, unknowingly, because of unintentional sins or occurrence of worldliness, one should understand, but I'm the right path. One should not get depressed. One should not get, you know, what is this? I'm trying to practice bhakti, but nothing is happening. So sometimes devotees can become very put off and give up Krishna consciousness. But one should know that whatever it is, I will not give the lotus feet of Krishna. Despite so many obstacles, despite so many anathas within my heart, despite so many obstacles, despite my inability to follow the principles, the regular principles, I'll keep on chanting Hare Krishna, I'll keep on associating with Vaishnavas, because that is the only hope. Why? Because that is the right path. Sooner or later, Lord's mercy, Vaishnava's mercy, Hari Guru Vaishnava's mercy will take us to the right destination. Therefore, the Lord, the facilities of devotional service are easily obtained by devotees. Why? Because they know the Sambhutim, they know the Vidya, that Lord is a person and he is a proprietor of everything. But the non-devotee, but the impersonalist, they don't get the facility of bhakti because they're attached to the Brahmojyoti feature of the Lord. Then Prabhupada mentioned about here Navida Bhakti. Yes, can some next devotee can read?
Hare Krishna. The facilities of devotional service are denied the impersonalists because they are attached to the Brahmajyoti feature of the Lord. As suggested in the previous mantras, they cannot penetrate the Brahmajyoti because they do not believe in the personality of the Godhead. Their business is mostly word jugglery and mental speculation. Consequently, the impersonalists pursue a fruitless labor, as confirmed in the 12th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, 12.5. All the facilities suggested in this mantra can be easily obtained by constant contact with the personal features of the Absolute Truth. Devotional service to the Lord consists of essentially essentially of 9 transcendental activities: hearing about the Lord, glorifying the Lord, remembering the Lord, serving the lotus feet of the Lord, worshipping the Lord, offering prayers to the Lord, serving the Lord, enjoying friendly association with the Lord, and surrendering everything unto the Lord. These 9 principles of devotional service, taken all together or one by one, help a devotee remain constantly in touch with God. In this way, at the end of life, it is easy for the devotee to remember the Lord. Only one of the 9 principles, the following renowned devotees of the Lord were able to achieve the highest perfection. Number 1, by hearing the Lord, Maharaj Parikshit, the hero of Srimad Bhagavatam, attained the desired result. Number 2, just by glorifying the Lord, Sukhdev Goswami, the speaker of Srimad Bhagavatam, attained his perfection. Number 3, by praying to the Lord, Akrura attained the desired result. Number 4, by remembering the Lord, Prahlad Maharaj attained the desired result. Number 5, by worshipping the Lord, Prithu Maharaj attained perfection. Number 6, by serving the lotus feet of the Lord, the goddess of fortune, Lakshmi, attained perfection. Number 7, by rendering personal service to the Lord, Hanuman attained the desired results. Number 8, through his friendship with the Lord, Arjuna attained the desired result. Number 9, by surrendering everything he had to the Lord, Maharaj Bali attained the desired result. Krishna, you want me to continue, Prabhu?
Yes, Prabhu. No, Prabhuji. Thank you for reading. Correct. So this is the glory of bhakti, that devotees, because they take up Vidya, Sambhutim, worship of Supreme Person, God in the person. So therefore, they get the facility. What is the facility they get? They get a facility of performing Navida Bhakti. Shavanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Archanam, Mundanam, Dasyam, Atma, Nivedanam, Iti, Pumsarpita, Vishnu, Bhaktishchena, Lakshana. So this is Bhaktishchena, Lakshana. And by practicing this, a person can immediately get in contact with the Lord. And the personality who practiced all 9 is Ambarish Maharaj. So this is the glory of Bhakti. It is so simple. And even not only all limbs of Bhakti you have to perfect, any one of the limbs of Bhakti you perfect, you can achieve success. Prabhupada writes in this, here only writes in this purport. So theme of this mantra and of all mantras of Vedic literature is properly explained in Srimad Bhagavatam, which is a mature fruit of Vedic tree of wisdom. So what is a mantra? Mantra is about death. What is Srimad Bhagavatam starting with? Srimad Bhagavatam starts with, okay, Parikshit Maharaj, he's been cursed by Sringi, and he's waiting for Sukhdev Goswami. And Variyane Shate Prashna, Napa Loka Hitam Rapa. So this has become this prashna which Parikshit Maharaj asked in the end of first canto, what is the duty of a dying man and what a dying person, duty of a person in general who has taken birth in this material world, what he should do. So 2.1.1 starts with Variyane Shate Prashna. Shotavyadi Rajendra Nunam Shanti Sarasrasa Apashatam Atmatattvam Graheshu Grahamitina. The people of this world, there is so much of literature, there is so much of Facebook, there is WhatsApp, there is newspaper, there is e-paper, so much available, so much news available. But they will simply Nidra Hriyate Naktam Vivayana Chayiva Dayacharta Hyarajan Kutumbu Varanenava. So the section of 2.1, 2, 3, 4 goes, and it comes to Tasmad Bharata Sarvatma Bhagavan Ishvara Hari Shotevya Kirtito Vasya Smartevya Ichchata Bhayam. That is the 5th shloka. So Prabhupada mentions this. So this is the theme. So all the Vedic literature, especially the Jnanaganda scripture, speaks of death, the fear of death, how to escape death. Because when Jnani comes to the platform of karma, I cannot be them, you get benefit by rotating cycle of birth and death, from growing to a Brahma Bhuvana Loka Punaravartana Arjuna. So again, I have to come back. So therefore, a Jnani or somebody who comes to the Upanishads or Vedic hymns, they want to escape death. So that is the whole theme of different mantras, and that is explained very nicely in Srimad Bhagavatam. Prabhupada speaks about it. Yes. Next devotee, who is there? Shilpa Matari, you can read actually from here.
Yeah, the name is Pranamsuji. Actually, the explanation of this mantra and of practically all the mantras of the Vedic hymns is summarized in Vedanta Sutra and properly explained in Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam is the mature fruit of the Vedic tree of wisdom. In Srimad Bhagavatam, this particular mantra is explained in the questions and answers between Maharaj Parikshit and Shukadev Goswami at the very beginning of their meeting. Hearing and chanting of the signs of God is the basic principle of devotional life. The complete Bhagavatam was heard by Maharaj Parikshit and chanted by Shukadev Goswami. Maharaj Parikshit inquired from Shukadev Goswami because Shukadeva was a greater spiritual master than any great yogi or transcendentalist of his time. Maharaj Parikshit's main question was, what is the duty of every man, specifically at the time of death? Shukadev Goswami answered, Tasmad Bharata Sarvatma Bhagwan Ishvaro Hari Shrotvai Kirti Tavyaschaha Smaratavyaschechatabhyam. Everyone who desires to be free from all anxieties should always hear about, glorify, and remember the personality of Godhead, who is the supreme director of everything, the extinguisher of all difficulties, and the super soul of all living entities. Srimad Bhagavatam 2.1.5. Hare Krishna.
Yes. So Prabhupada concludes here. The Shariram, he takes the Shariram aspect, comes to the Bhakti aspect, then he understands what practicing Bhakti we are, where is human, therefore he commits mistake, explains about Sudhuracharo, how he protects a devotee, and then he comes that same, this what mantra is speaking, this is very nicely elaborated in Vedanta Sutra, especially Srimad Bhagavatam in the second chapter, first five verses. So one who has learned the art of sacrifice by employing his senses in the service of the Lord can utilize the result of such practice at the time of death. Basically, this mantra speaks at the time of death. So therefore, whole Bhagavatam second canto, first chapter speaks about death. It begins with death. Varyane shate prashna. Mrita loka itam napaha. It is very much beneficial to the people in general. And it is a subject matter of people who are devotees and people who are about to this world. And therefore, how we can remember Krishna at the time of death? One, we have understood, we have come to the point of dotaining our senses in Krishna's service. And slowly from dotaining, we come to the point of sacrificing our sense gratification by employing our senses in Krishna's service. We can utilize that result at the time of death. Prabhupada concludes with that. Okay. So we have next devotee, Nirupam Mataji, you can read.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, Dandavat Pranam.
Yes, Mataji, from your so-called human society.
So-called human society is generally engaged at night in sleeping and having sex, and during the daytime in earning as much money as possible, or else in shopping for family maintenance. People have very little time to talk about the personality of Godhead or to inquire about him. They have dismissed God's existence in so many ways, primarily by declaring him to be impersonal, that is, without sense perception. But in the Vedic literature, whether the Upanishads, Vedanta Sutra, Bhagavad Gita, or Srimad Bhagavatam, it is declared that the Lord is a sentient being and is supreme over all other living entities. His glorious activities are identical with himself. One should therefore not indulge in hearing and speaking of the rubbish activities of worldly politicians and so-called big men in society, but should mold his life in such a way that he can engage in godly activities without wasting a second. Sri Ishopanishad directs us towards such godly activities. Unless one is accustomed to devotional practice, what will he remember at the time of death when the body is dislocated, and how can he pray to the Almighty Lord to remember his sacrifices? Sacrifice means denying the interest of the senses. One has to learn this art by employing the senses in the service of the Lord during one's lifetime. One can utilize the results of such practice at the time of death. Hare Krishna.
So Prabhupada speaks about 2.1.2 Nidra Hayate Naktam, and then people are simply interested in everything except God. So, but by hearing about the Lord, one can mold one's life. We should mold our life in such a way that engage in godly activities without a second. It's very important. The consciousness matters a lot. So we have to work a lot on our internal conscious. Yes, we can do a lot of achievements, we can do a lot of accomplishments, but more than accomplishment, attitude matters a lot. There's something called as accomplishment and attitude. In the outside world, so anyway, accomplishment and attitude doesn't matter anything. We come to Bhakti, what matters a lot? Attitude is more important than accomplishment. Example of squirrel and Hanuman. Squirrel was trying to do its accomplishment, but the attitude of service, Hanumanji, yes, he was also trying to do something, but he was telling, oh, what the squirrel is doing, get aside. But Lord Ram came inside, came and told, no, what service you are doing? That squirrel also trying to do that service. But just because it is not in equal in accomplishment to you, doesn't matter that I will not accept his service, I accept his service. So in the moment of Hare Krishna movement, some people are like Hanumanji, they can carry a lot of loads, and yes, Lord will accept their service. And some maximum of us are like squirrels, and Lord will accept our service also. And therefore, sacrificing means denying the interest of the senses. So this is attitude. It is more than accomplishment, it's attitude. So the attitude one has to learn is act by employing the senses in the service of the Lord during one's lifetime. And one can utilize this result of such practice at the time of death. So therefore, Prabhupada has coined this movement as International Society for Krishna Consciousness, so that we can work on our consciousness, we can work on our attitude, and whoever we are, the favorite pictures, or we are housewives, or we are trying to work in software company, or we are retired, whatever it is, what matters, what attracts Lord most is the spirit of service, the attitude of pleasing Hari, Guru and Vaishnava. That matters more than anything else. So it's like one Tulsi Satyamama is, Rukmini ji is trying to put, when Narad Muni is trying to call and find out, I'll give your Radha Krishna back to you, provided you give me equal amount of gold. Then Rukmini Devi comes, brings a one Tulsi and puts there, and then everything goes up. All accomplishments goes up. So that is the power of Bhakti. So Bhakti is about attitude with which we want to please Hari, Guru and Vishnu. So let's go to the next mantra without not much spending a lot of time again. Mantra 18. I'll just share the screen.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, so much sound is here. Hare.
Yeah. It's not audible.
Please mute that sound is more than your sound, your this.
Okay. Thank you. So the next mantra, we'll start with this. Mantra 18.
Abhinaya supataraye asman Vishwani deva vayunani chvidvan Yodhyasma juranameno Bhuvistam tenamu yuktim videma Abhinaya supataraye asman Vishwani deva vayunani vidvan Yodasma juranameno bhuvishtam teno nama yuktim videma agninaya supataraye asman vishvani deva vayunani vidvan yodasma juranameno eno bhuvishtam te nama yuktim videma.
Yes, can one devotee recite?
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, can I do that? Agnenaya supadaraye asman Vishwani deva vayunani vidvan Yudhoi asmaj juhuranam eno Bhuishtam te nama uktim vidhema.
Krishna Prabhuji. Agne Naya Supadha Rayo Asman Vishwani Deva Vayo Nani Vidvan Yuyodha Smadha Puranamo No Bhuistam De Nama Yukta Videma.
So word to word meaning Agne. Oh my Lord, as powerful as fire, Naya, kindly lead Supataha by the right path, Raya, for reaching you. Asman, us, Vishwani, all, Deva, O my Lord, Vayunani, actions, Vidwan, the knower, Yodhi, Yodhi, kindly remove, Asmat from us, Juhuranam, all hindrances on the path, Ena, all vices, Bhuishtam, most numerous, Te, unto you, Nama, Uktim, Namaktim, words of obeisances, Videma, I do. So it's the last verse of our Ishopanishad discussion, translation and purport by His Divinity, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. O my Lord, as powerful as fire, O omnipotent one, now I offer you all obeisances, falling on the ground at your feet. O my Lord, please lead me on the right path to reach you. And since you know all that I have done in the past, please free me from the reactions to my past sins so that there will be no hindrances to my progress. So basically till now, the prayer has been to remove the Hiranmaya Patrena, remove the effulgence. You are having a beautiful form. That is 15, 16. 17 has been let the body, subtle body, get merged and with totality. And then remember my sacrifices, what I have done. Sacrifices means sacrificing sense gratification and engaging Krishna's service. So Prabhupada writes more on somebody who has engaged in Krishna consciousness in his lifetime, he can think of Krishna at the time of death. So that was about positive engagement in Krishna's service. Here, the last prayer is about, the final conclusion is about, please read me on the right path, Sudarshana. The Lord's chakra is called Sudarshana. Please lead me on the right path to reach you. And since you know all that I've done in the past, because Lord knows past, present, future. And Lord knows whatever things we have done, sinful, vikarmic, akarmic, and karmic. Lord knows everything. So devotee is asking here, forgiveness, please free me from the reactions to my past sins so that there will be no hindrances to my progress. So sometimes it is sinful, intentional, sometimes it is unintentional. So here, this last prayer is about to clear the path back to Godhead, and whatever reactions to unmeditated sins, unintentional sins, the devotee is asking to remove the hindrance caused by such reactions in this mantra here. So Prabhupada begins the purport with bhakti is a very, very powerful path compared to karma. He compares in the first half of the section, Prabhupada compares the path of bhakti with karma and jnana kanda. And bhakti is fruitful and glorious, while karma kanda path is fruitless and risky. And then Prabhupada, in the second point, Prabhupada, second paragraph, Prabhupada mentions about human form of life is valuable. But after getting a human form of life, after getting a birth in a Shrutinam Shrimatam Gheve, one should not become proud of one's Brahminical culture and stop practicing bhakti. Then one will misutilize the human form of life. But one should take up bhakti very seriously. Prabhupada mentions that. And he explains that even a chandala can become a pure devotee by the power of bhakti, which is beyond karma and jnana. And even a great-born brahmana can be lower than the chandala by neglecting bhakti. Therefore, superiority of bhakti compared to karma kanda and jnana kanda in third paragraph. And then Prabhupada mentions about how Lord, omnipotent Lord, protects a devotee from unintentional sins. A devotee does not do sins intentionally, but unintentional sins, Lord protects, purifies a devotee from that. Prabhupada mentioned in the fourth section. And then in the last section, devotee guided by the spiritual master, the Vedic injunctions, the Lord himself from within is protected from the mire of mental illusion and is sure to reach the perfection. Prabhupada ends the purport with that. So it's a small purport with five to six paragraphs. So I'll try to discuss it in next half an hour. We may go a little 5 minutes extra today, but this is our last session. So that your Wednesday's class is waived off so that we can complete this nicely. So can some devotees start volunteer reading this purport? It's very simple. Vene Mataji, I think you resigned. Start with this first section.
Hare Krishna. Path of bhakti is fruitful and glorious, while karmakanda path is fruitless and risky. By surrendering to the Lord and praying for his causeless mercy, the devotee can progress on the path of complete self-realization. The Lord is addressed as fire because he can burn anything into ashes, including the sins of surrendered soul. As described in the previous mantras, the real or ultimate aspect of the absolute is his feature as the personality of Godhead, and his impersonal Brahmacharya feature is a dazzling covering over his face. Fruitive activities or the Karmakanda path of self-realization is the lowest stage in this endeavor. As soon as such activities even slightly deviate from the regulative principles of the Vedas, they are transformed into vikarma or acts against the interest of the actor. Such vikarma is enacted by the illusioned living entity simply for sense gratification, and thus such activities become hindrances on the path of self-realization. Hare Krishna.
Yes. Can someone recollect some Shastric example where a karma person is trying to do a karma kanda from Bhagavatam or somewhere, and he was like, got the result of doing performing vikarma, animal species, in the next life? Yes.
Bharat Maharaj.
Oh, Bharat Maharaj was engaged in bhakti, but somebody engaged in karma kanda.
Indra.
Yes.
Indra Devata.
Oh, yes. Can you tell the what is the example? What happened to that person engaging like that?
He was then was born as a hog and was there for thousands, millions of years as a hog. Because for sense gratification, and he had forgotten completely. So
okay,
I don't know more than that, Prabhuji. I'm sorry.
Okay. Someone else. Somebody was engaged in karma kanda. Author is trying to do so-called. Yes.
It is Daksha Prajapati.
Yes. Can you tell what is the
he offends Lord Shiva.
Okay, so but he was trying to
do the karmakandic act.
It was not karmakanda. Basically, that is example of in Bhagavatam comes in fourth canto. It's example for someone. Lord Kapila mentions about 81 types of bhakti by practitioner. Tamoguna, rajoguna, satvaguna. It comes in a devotee practicing in tamoguna. But not karmakanda. Somebody is trying to do karmakanda and then he suffers in the next life. Although his intentions are to do good charity. It comes in 10th canto. Can someone recollect? No? No recollections? It comes in the 10th canto of Bhagavatam. Prabhupada also writes in the Krishna book, the story of King Raga. King Raga was there and he used to give at a proper. There the mention comes of lots of crores of cows. But how he used to find is to find an auspicious time. In that auspicious time, he used to come and donate a cow to a Brahmana in the right time, in the right place. And that is to be equivalent to 1,000 or 10, 1, like that. So in that way, he used to see time and in that time try to captivate on the karmic part of that charity. And one day what happened, one cow, it went and escaped and went to some other, came back again to his kingdom. And the same cow was given charity to some other Brahmana. But the first Brahmana became angry on him and cursed him. Then he became a lizard in the next life. But somehow there was a touch of Krishna. Therefore, he became a lizard in Krishna's courtyard. And then when the Yadavas had gone to the jungle, they saw him and Krishna delivered him. Because it was not only just Karma Kanda, but this is not an example of Karma Kanda, but the example of person who is trying to practice, trying to utilize Vedic literature, trying to do bhakti, but with karma into a lot of significance. And therefore, he got the mercy of Krishna in the next life. But here, this paragraph, what is speaking about the people who are like, imagine if he had no intention of serving cows in relation to Lord Vishnu, then there was no guarantee that he could have been blessed with Lord Krishna's mercy in the next life. Imagine somebody simply doing karma kanda yajna, karma kanda kind of rituals or something like that. So imagine somebody get cursed to become a lizard. What is the guarantee? 84 lakh species has to wait to come back to the human form of life. So it's a very risky path. It's not so easy. But bhakti is like right from the beginning, one person can completely get elevated, beginner. He can be completely purified. There is no danger. One can, in 11th canto it comes, one can blindfold and run on this path. Why? Because it's the right path. There can be occasional pauses, slips, fall downs, but still, even like in the Bharat Maharaj's case, in three lifetimes a person can go on. But sure shot, one who has practiced bhakti, once begun, one is forcefully dragged to success. I think Prabhupada writes in Nectar of Instruction, one who has practiced begin bhakti, it takes a practitioner forcefully dragged to success. Yes. Next, Shubhrabhu, can you read the next theme?
From the cell, okay. Although human form is, I can't see it properly, Prabhu, there. Although human, that's the paragraph, right, Prabhu? Although human form is sudarlabham and ardham, one should not become proud of high parentage and the loss and lose the good opportunity of self-realization. Okay. Self-realization is possible in the human form of life, but not in other forms. There are 84 lakh species or forms of life, of which human form qualified by Brahminical culture presents the only chance to obtain knowledge of transcendence. Brahminical culture includes truthfulness, sense control, forbearance, simplicity, full knowledge, and full faith in God. It's not that one simply becomes proud of his high parentage. Just as being born the son of a big man affords one a chance to become a big man, so being born the son of a Brahmana gives one a chance to become a Brahmana. But such a birthright is not everything, for one still has to attain the Brahminical qualifications for himself. As soon as one becomes proud of his birth as the son of a Brahmana and neglects to acquire the qualification of a real Brahmana, he at once becomes degraded and falls from the path of self-realization. Thus, his life's mission as a human being is defeated. In Bhagavad Gita 6.41 and 6.42, we are assured by the Lord that the yoga brastas are souls fallen from the path of self-realization are given a chance to rectify themselves by taking the birth either in the families of good Brahmanas or in the families of rich merchants. Such births afford higher chance of self-realization. If these chances are misused due to the illusion, one loses the good opportunity of human life afforded by the Almighty Lord. Krishna.
Yes. Therefore, after reading Shrutinam Srimatam ki, one should not become proud of because of his high parentage. Janmeshwar Shruti Shibir, Edaman Edapuman, Naivarte Magidatum Vel Tamakinchana Gocharam. What attacks Krishna is not the proud of the high parentage or our beauty or our knowledge or our richness, but it's humility. When we out of humility, when we surrender to Krishna, Krishna gets attracted. Therefore, bhakti is superior to karma and jnana. Yes, someone can read next. Shri Giriraj Prabhu, I think, has read. Yes, Prabhu can read. Poonam Agarwal Mataji, can you read? Yes, who yeah.
Superiority of bhakti process in comparison to karma kanda and jnana kanda. The regulative principles are such that one who follows them is promoted from the platform of fruitative activities to the platform of transcendental knowledge. After many, many lifetimes of cultivating transcendental knowledge, one becomes perfect when he surrenders onto the Lord. This is the great procedure. But one who surrenders at the very beginning, as recommended in this mantra, at once surpasses all preliminary stages simply by adopting the devotional attitude. As stated in Bhagavad Gita 18.66, the Lord at once takes charge of such a surrendered soul and frees him from all the reactions to his sinful acts. There are many sinful reactions involved in karma kanda activities, whereas in jnana kanda, the path of philosophical development, the number of such sinful activities is smaller. But in devotional service to the Lord, the path of bhakti, there is practically no chance of incurring sinful reactions because a devotee of the Lord attains all the good qualifications of the Lord himself, what to speak of those of a Brahmana. A devotee automatically attains the qualification of an expert Brahmana authorized to perform sacrifices, even though the devotee may not have taken his birth in a Brahmana family. Such is the omnipotence of the Lord. He can make a man born in a Brahmana family as degraded as the low-born dog-eater, and he can also make a low-born dog-eater superior to a qualified Brahmana simply on the strength of devotional service.
Yes. So this is the superiority of bhakti compared to the path of jnana and karma, which is having a lot of sinful activities. Though karma may have a lot and jnana may have less, but bhakti, the practical notions of incurring sinful action, because it is about alignment, acceptance, alignment, acting for the pleasure and acting on behalf of the Lord. Therefore, Lord being omnipotent, present in the heart, he can do anything. Omnipotent means Lord can do anything. He can make a man born who is proud to lower than dog, low born dog. Many times we see people coming from very cultured southern families, they go to west and they eat beef. On the other hand, the westerners who are born eating dogs and other things, they take up bhakti, they give up everything. They start wearing dhuti kurta and saris, and they start following Hari principles, and they start leading a very pure life. Kirata hunandra pulinda kulpashe ine pape. So that is a glory. So this is what Prabhupada is writing here. So cultured people who are born in Brahmin family, they have got opportunity Shruti Nam Shivatam Gi, but then instead of that, they become lower, less than the dog eaters. Because dog eater is much better than a person who eats beef. But person who is dog eater, Chandala, he is elevated to bhakti. That is the glory of bhakti. This comes in Lord Kapila. Lord Kapila is glorifying the pursuit of bhakti. How a person born as a doctor, he becomes qualified by practicing bhakti. So omnipotent Lord protects a devotee from unintentional sins. So bhakti is very powerful compared to karma and jnana. It is free of sinful reactions of karma and jnana. But because of past conditions again, because the prayer is, oh my Lord, kindly forgive my reactions. Please clear off the reactions of sinful activities in my life and clear the path back to you. So that this Prabhupada is mentioning here, that path of omnipotent Lord protects a devotee from unintentional sins. Yes, we have next devotee, Chandramouli Prabhu. You can read from here.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Prabhu. You can read, yeah.
Since the omnipotent Lord is situated within the heart of everyone, he can give directions to his sincere devotees by which they can attain the right path. Such directions are especially offered to the devotee, even if he desires something else. As far as others are concerned, God gives sanction to the doer only at the risk of the doer. But in the case of a devotee, the Lord directs him in such a way that he never acts wrongly. Srimad Bhagavatam says, Swapada Mula. Can I read, Prabhuja, or you read?
Yeah, you can read.
Svapada mulam bhajata priyasya taktantya bhavasya hari pare pareshah vikarmaya kot patitam katanchit dunoti sarvam hrudi sanvistah. The Lord is so kind to the devotee who is fully surrendered to his lotus feet, that even though the devotee sometimes falls into the entanglement of vikarma acts against the Vedic. Against the Vedic directions. The Lord at once rectifies such mistakes from within his heart. This is because the devotees are very dear to the Lord. In this mantra of the Sri Ishopanishad, the devotee prays to the Lord to rectify him from within his heart. To err is human. A conditioned soul is very often apt to commit mistakes, and the only remedial measure to take against such unintentional sins is to give oneself up to the lotus feet of the Lord so that he may guide one to avoid such pitfalls. the Lord takes charge of fully surrendered souls. Thus, all problems are solved simply by surrendering oneself unto the Lord and acting in terms of His directions. Such directions are given to the sincere devotee in two ways. One is by way of the saints, scriptures, and spiritual master, and the other is by way of the Lord Himself, who resides within the heart of everyone. Thus, the devotee, fully enlightened with Vedic knowledge, is protected in all respects.
Yes, true. So that is the thing. So the path of bhakti is that Lord forgives the unintentional sins. So this shloka very nicely speaks about it, that Lord is so kind to devotees, fully surrendered to His lotus feet, that sometimes falls into entanglement of vikarma acts against the Vedic direction. The Lord at once rectifies his mistakes from within his heart. This is because the devotees are very dear to the Lord. So to err is a human. So this paragraph, very, very important paragraph. The conditioned soul is very often apt to commit mistakes, and the only remedial measure to take against such unintentional sins is to give up oneself up to the lotus feet of the Lord so that He may guide one to avoid such pitfalls. The Lord takes charge of fully surrendered souls. Thus, all problems are solved simply by surrendering oneself unto the Lord. And what are the direction? One is by Lord takes charge of the fully surrendered soul by two ways. By sadhu, guru, shastras, saints, scriptures, and spiritual master, and by Lord within the heart He purifies. So He fully enlightens the devotee in all prospects. So in this way, is protected in all respect by the unintentional sins. Because Lord is within his heart, so he gets all protection. Therefore, such pitfalls the Lord ignores. Yes, last section now. We are coming to the last section. Can the next devotee read? Sunil Prabhu, please read the next section.
Hare Krishna. A devotee guided by the spiritual master, the Vedic injunction, and the Lord Himself from within is protected from the mire of material illusion and sure to reach perfection. Vedic knowledge is transcendental and cannot be understood by mundane educational procedures. One can understand the Vedic mantras only by the grace of the Lord and the spiritual master. Yasya deva para bhaktir yatha deve tatha guram. 6.23. If one takes shelter of a bona fide spiritual master, it is to be understood that he has obtained the grace of the Lord. The Lord appears as the spiritual master for the devotee. Thus, the spiritual master, the Vedic injunctions, and the Lord Himself from within all guide the devotee in full strength. In this way, there is no chance for a devotee to fall again into the mire of material illusion. The devotee, thus protected all round, is sure to reach the ultimate destination of perfection. The entire process is hinted at in this mantra and Srimad Bhagavatam 1.2.17-20 explain it further. Hearing and chanting the glories of the Lord is itself an act of piety. The Lord wants everyone to hear and chant His glories because He is the well-wisher of all living entities. By hearing and chanting the glories of the Lord, one becomes clean of all undesirable things, and then one's devotion becomes fixed upon the Lord. At this stage, the devotee acquires the Brahmanical qualification and the effects of the lower modes of nature, passion and ignorance, completely vanish. The devotee becomes fully enlightened by virtue of his devotional service, and thus he comes to know the path of the Lord and the way to attain Him. As all doubts diminish, he becomes a pure devotee. The knowledge that brings one nearer to the Supreme Lord.
Hare Krishna. So we have successfully completed the Ishopanishad. And these are the 18 mantras of Sri Ishopanishad. The first section is one invocation. Prabhupada speaks about Vedas, the invocation. And then Prabhupada, then there is a section of living in harmony, mantra 1, 2, 3. Then for mantra 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 is about the vision of Mahabhagavat. Then comparison of knowledge, 9, 10, 11, comparison of worship, 12, 13, 14, and 15, 16, 17, 18 is about prayers. So this is in gist. Sri Ishopanishad brings a person from Om Purnamadaha, completeness. Tat, everywhere it's mentioned tat, 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 and slowly it comes to the personality of form of Lord, where one comes to pray for to be excused from, to reveal his form in 15-16, then to remember his sacrifice, and the last, to excuse unintentional sins in the reaction for sinful activities. So any questions any one of you have regarding this whole section, you can put forward. We have 8 minutes time. I was thinking it will take a lot, but then the last purport was very small, so we just ended it. And if any questions, you can ask. Otherwise, we'll try to end before time. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Yes, Prabhu.
Prabhu, in that in the purport, it's mentioned that, you know, the Lord's omnipotence. You know, he can also degrade and downgrade a brahmana to become a dog eater. And you know, he can elevate a dog eater from that position to be a brahmana also. When the Lord loves his devotee so much, then why does he allow us to downgrade?
Free will. Free will. The Lord doesn't make us. Lord is a silent observer. Upadrishta Anumanta Bharta Bhukta Maheshwaram Paramatma. But we have a free will. You have to take our free will and hand it over to him. So that is section being spoken there.
That's why he says the risk is with the doer.
Mm. Basically, section is regarding higher parentage. Somebody may be born in a higher parent, you know, big Brahmana family, but then he become puffed up and may not practice bhakti. Then he has lost the chance. And on the other hand, a person who may not be born in a Brahmana family, but he can become a pure devotee by following a pure devotee's instruction, Guru Shadu Shastra in his life. That is the whole section, basically. That is what Prabhupada is trying to compare there. Hare Krishna,
Prabhuji. Prabhuji, earlier you mentioned that those who end their life suddenly due to some, you know, accident or anything, and if they have some bhakti, and it can continue in the next life, right? But I mean, again, this whenever they take the next life, how they can remember, because everything is lost, right? Again, it's like completely blank, and they will try to use their free will to continue. So is it really, is it a mercy of the God that we can get the bhakti can be continued from where we left off, or how is that possible?
Yes, it's a mercy of the Lord only. That sarvasya chayan vidhi sannivishtu matya smithir jnanam upavanam cha. So he's sitting in everybody's heart and he gives a knowledge, forgetfulness and remembrance. Forgetfulness of sin, horrible activities. Forgetfulness of the modes of death we might have died. And remembrance of our past bhakti, what you have done. Sukruti, bhakti unmukha sukruti, or the yoga. Brashtas, if you become yoga brashtas, then whatever yoga siddhi we are following, that continues. Suddenly we see some people, you just give them book, you are trying to do Bhagavad Gita, distribute Bhagavad Gita and train somewhere, and you are trying to show and trying to speak 10-15 minutes, notice taking, but suddenly some person comes from somewhere, takes it and starts reading it.
Mm-hmm.
And he comes to start coming to center, start chanting, first day one start chanting, after within 1 week, 16 rounds. Within 6 months, you know, all manga, all Ekadashis and this and that. And you can see within very, very short time, we can just pick up bhakti like anything. So it is from not from this life, past life. Mm-hmm. Why? Because bhakti is there with a soul. When we leave the body, the gross body made up of earth, water, fire, ether, that gets burnt. But the mind influences ego, the subtle body, along with the soul. So bhakti is stored in the soul. Bhakti is with the soul. And our whatever skills and talents, accomplishments, the anything we have, that comes, that is stored in the memory in the form of subtle body, mind, lens and ego. And therefore, that continues the next life.
Mm-hmm.
Material accomplishments, expertise, that go into subtle body. Therefore, people are very smart, like smart CEOs and everyone. Some people are born with silver spoon. They can, within 15, 16 years, they can become big entrepreneurs, 17, 18 years. So these are people who are, got that from not from this. So yes, so material expertise can be carried over to the next, so spirituality can surely be carried to the next.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, But what is the point? Material expertise. That material expertise is harnessed when it is engaged in Krishna service. Therefore, Neha Vikrama Nashasti Pratyavena Vidyate. Svarupam Piyasya Dharmasya Trayato Mahato Bhayat. It helps us one who helps a living entity, jivan form. It helps one to get a human form of life in the next life. Bhakti process. But material expertise alone without bhakti is not fruitful. It is risky. One can become animal in the next life also. That is what we discussed in this
paper. But the, so Prabhuji, the material expertise, like, you know, sometimes we will say that people who are born talented, whether maybe they are in a subject wise or maybe like, you know, Sachin Tendulkar, who is born talented in sports. So that is also because of their past karma, Prabhuji?
Yes. You see, anywhere, anything, any, this vibhuti is being manifested. Anywhere anybody is getting his big fan following, anything, that is because of karma. That is not because of some activities in this life. That is karma. If you see astrology, that is called as Raj Yoga in astrology.
Okay, that's a part of it. But they don't use it for any devotional activity. It's purely on the material
aspect. Yeah, that, therefore I told, what is the use of material activity? Tektva sadardam bhajatam. If one gives up material life to practice bhakti, what is the harm? If one practices while, if what one is becomes very material expert and gives up bhakti, what is what he has saved? That is what Narada Muni is telling to Vedavas.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji. Hare Krishna, yeah. Prabhuji.
Yes.
That in the open book exam, one question is there regarding personal form of the Lord. We have to establish in our own world, sir. In the, yes, bracket, it is for a personal application. That please explain me, what is that personal application you have to take?
I think Vamshi Vedan Prabhu had taken a session where it explained you different different themes of Bhakti Shastri study. Personal application means there is something called preaching application. You have to give a class, you know, new people are coming, or you're going in a train and somebody comes and, you know, inquires, okay, chanting, but Lord is impersonal. But you start speaking from the information what you read here. It's called preaching application. Personal application means in your own thing, since childhood we have been worshipping, we may come across from some South India where everything is shown, yeah, Brahma Satyam, Jagat Mithyam, and impersonal concept. But how in our own life we can come to the conclusion that not Lord has a form. That is not for preaching application, but for our understanding. That is the difference. Okay? That is personal application.
Our own experience you have to write. That's what you mean, sir? You mean Prabhuji?
Basically, yes, yes. We have to write it from our point of view. This is not meant for others. Preaching application means for trying to teach others or prove others or preach to others. Personal application means our own understanding from Ishopanishad or from Bhagavad Gita. We have to quote, which strengthens our own understanding and bhakti and the personality of form.
Thank you, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Dandavat Pranam.
Yes.
One question, Prabhuji. I read somewhere saying that, okay, the past karmas, okay, which we have acquired in this life or previous life, are always fight with the kind of effort what we are putting in this life. Okay, somebody won a gold medal, Prabhuji, but he would have put lot of effort in this age. Otherwise, it would have not possible, right? So how do we understand that, Prabhuji? Because now we are talking about the kind of some of the celebrities are getting lot of name, but in this life they would have put lot of effort, no, Prabhuji.
Practice makes man perfect. So both thing, not only from last life, this life also it's required. It's not that, you know, nice upchasa simmas here. Without hard work, living entity, a deer will not come and sit in lion's mouth. So basically, one thing we should understand, without background of past supporting, without daiva, how much you endeavor, you can't be successful. How many people they want to go in the Indian cricket team? By only wife, a few get selected. And people who don't believe in daiva or don't believe in Bhagwan, they make it a thing, okay, you can win, you can do all these things, by hard work, you can climb the ladder of success. They try to give such motivational classes. But till the time your bhagya is not supported, you can't climb the ladder of success. That is sure. Okay, both desire and deserve. Desire and deserve. You should deserve also, and you should desire also. Both things are there. The same thing I expect is for getting a next body. something from the Ishopanishad, it is going to some other thing of karma and other things. If you don't have any inquiries, then we'll end now. Hare Krishna. All the best for your exams, open book, closed book.
Thank you for exams.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Nice discussion with all of you. Bye. All of you are... Yes.
Am I audible, Prabhuji? One quick question. Prabhuji, I'm just wondering, right, what is the difference between a sin and offense? Paap and aparad. Is there any difference?
Yes, big difference. Sin is on material platform and aparad is on spiritual platform.
Okay.
Sin can be easily cleansed, aparad cannot be easily cleansed.
Okay.
So sin can be easily overcome, but aparadhi is very, very dangerous. One can lose one's bhakti only.
Okay. All right, Prabhuji. All right, Prabhuji. Hare. Thank you. Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. I personally want to thank you for your crystal clear classes and your hard work on each of your document that you were sharing with all highlighting and all that. It is really helpful. Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Therefore, I got a very nice opportunity while trying to discuss this Ishopanishad with all of you. My study of Ishopanishad became very rock solid. So these notes which I made, this is because for all, this is something which is very technical and this is on the online platform. If it is physical, then we can have board, we can have PPTs and other things. But then to read, to carry on with this such a technical thing. So this will go into eternal, not eternal, this will go in nice homework part, which I can use in future anytime. So it is once this Ishopanishad notes are made now. Okay, thank you all of you for your
patience.
Can you please forward to last few words?
Please send all the documents, Prabhuji.
Yes, I have sent in mantra 11 to Subhura Prabhu's mail ID. Is it not, Prabhuji? I have sent, already sent. Remaining 10, you can check. Okay, if you want, I can send all once again, one shot. We can share.
I'll check, Prabhu. Okay.
From 12 onwards, I'll send. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. I'll send the documents. Okay?
Hare Krishna.
So, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna,
Prabhuji. Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Thank you very much, Prabhuji.
And all the questions will come mostly from that only. Whatever book we have, 90%. So, 10% will come from here and there. And the closed book is as usual. Briefly explain 2 marks. And then analogy, 10 marks. Then there'll be short answers of 2 marks each. Then there'll be big answers of 4 marks. Totally, it may be of either 50 or 100 marks. But it'll be simple. No need to worry. You can study from the section, question answers, which is behind. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Thank you very much. Lilan 2 is there? Or?
No, Prabhu. Okay. No, Prabhu.
Yes. You can convey my official books to him. So I'm very grateful that he engaged me in his service. So thank you so much for the service which you have given to me. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Thank you so much for your service, Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.